Hey there, Jason Podolin from Up My Hockey, back with another Lessons from a Pro. And this is a segment where I help hockey players reach their goals and reach their dreams, which is what I do on a daily basis. And these YouTube videos and the interviews that I do are really just a supporting feature of how I help athletes. And today we're going to talk about player identity, because this is a common problem that I see with not only my clients, but everywhere across the board when it comes to midget players, bantam players, junior players, collegiate players, even pro players, where people think, or players think, they need to be something that maybe they aren't. It's called player identity. And understanding your identity as a player early and clearly will benefit you a ton as a hockey player. Now, we can obviously grow from whatever this identity is, but usually there's a foundational piece to every player, a part that makes them who they are, that makes them special. And if you do that well, then everything else will take care of itself. And this is a three-part series. There's a conversation I had with Jared Bednar about Nazem Kadri. There's a conversation I had with Jeff Finley, who is a scout for the Winnipeg Jets, about his time with Luke Shen at the junior level during his draft year. And there's also a conversation that I heard on the NHL Network with Mike Rupp talking about his own personal experience playing with Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin and what Dan Bylsma said to him. So there's three different clips here. They all are very similar in nature. They will all help you as a player and help you understand the value of knowing what your player identity is. This lesson is inspired by a story, Jeff Finley, 700-game NHL defenseman Jeff Finley, NHL scout for the Winnipeg Jets Jeff Finley, told me about Luke Shen. And it's all focused on player identity. And player identity, the ability to self-assess and understand who you are as a player, is one of the greatest gifts and one of the most powerful things you can ever understand as a player. And so many players get caught up in not understanding what they are and instead focus on what they want to be or what they think they should be or what maybe they think they can be, that it gets in the way of what they're doing right now and it's holding them back. So listen to this story from Jeff, and I'll tell you a little bit more about player identity after you hear the clip.
I coached Luke Shen in Kelowna, and he was, back then when he was in his draft year, you could tell what type of player he was going to be at the NHL level, exactly what he's turned into, a hard, rugged, stay-at-home, shut-down type of player. He was obsessed with his points. Like every day he'd come in and worry about he wasn't getting enough points because he was worried about that part of his game for the draft. And we were getting frustrated, to be honest with you. Like, Luke, like the team that drafts you isn't drafting you to run their power play. So be great at what you're good at, you know, like, and he went right to the NHL. So when he was 19, so he figured it out, but you're exactly right. Everyone's so focused on production and not realizing there's so much more to the game, especially for different players. Like it takes all kinds of players to make up a team, right?
That story told about Luke Shen by Jeff Finley, who was once the assistant coach there with the Kelowna Rockets of the WHL during Luke's draft year. And Jeff is now a scout for the Winnipeg Jets. That story is invaluable because it is a direct reflection of what is happening on junior teams and on major midget teams and teams all over North America with players that want to do something that they don't necessarily need to do. There's a resistance with their identity, with their role on the team, and that resistance isn't allowing them to do what they do great. Players who want to get a scholarship or who want to get drafted or they want to, they aspire to bigger things are almost always to a fault focused on production, offensive production. Yet if you talk to people who architect teams, scouts who look at players, people who are involved behind the scenes in trying to produce championships, they're not all the same type of player. You can't have six guys on defense that are going to run your power play. You can't have nine perimeter forwards that want to dangle from the outside.
you need to have players that will do different things. And it breaks my heart when I see players who are gifted one way, but are striving, aspiring to be something that they're not. If you can defend, and if you can be rugged, and if you can be mean, do it. Because there's so many players right now who can't do that. They're small, they're skilled, they're fast, but they don't want to go to the dirty areas. They don't want to get gritty. They don't want to risk a bruise, right? So use what you have. And if that means you're a defenseman that gets the puck out, and you're a defenseman that protects your net, and you're a defenseman that doesn't get scored on, teams need you. I promise that. If you're a forward who's in a third line role right now and who likes to crash and likes to go to the front of the net and likes to go to the dirty areas and get rebounds and likes to play physical and the other defense know that you're on the ice because you forecheck hard, do that. Do that to the best of your ability every night and you will get noticed. Not everybody's going to have a hat trick or a goal and two assists. Because guess what? Like I said earlier, at the end of the day, there's only so many guys that are going to be on a power play. And there's only so many guys that are going to be looked on to score goals. And the rest of the team needs to be effective doing something else. So be competitive in your own way. Understand what your identity is, especially on the team you're at right now. And do that really well. And if that expands into a role that's offensive, fantastic. But if it doesn't, you've created an identity, you've created your niche, your thing that you can focus on. Because when you are trying to do something else, or you're trying to do too many things at once, you become effective at nothing. And when you become effective at nothing, the coach loses interest and trust. The scouts don't know what they're getting. But for a guy like Luke Shen, who's a great example, he wanted to get points almost to a fault. He only ended up with 20-some points in like 57 games. But scouts saw what he was. He was a big, rugged player that was going to be a great defender, and he could do that at the NHL level. And he went fifth overall in the draft. You can get drafted high. You can be desired by many teams and not have tons of points on the board. And Luke figured it out. He ended up being figured out on his own, or whether with the help of the coaches like Jeff Finley, or whether from the organization that drafted him. He ended up figuring out what he needed to be an NHL player. He made that jump at 19, and that's what he's been. And he almost has 1,000 games under his belt right now. It's not flashy. It's not maybe glory-driven. It's not going to be headlines in the paper. But if you're a hockey player, and if you want a job, and if that's what you want, then own what you are. It's all about self-assessing and knowing your identity and doing that really well.
And now we'll hear a slightly different story from Jared Bednar and my episode 82 podcast of Up My Hockey, where Jared is talking about Nazem Kadri and why he is experiencing so much success this year and how he has to walk this line, Nazem, of understanding what he is in order to have the offense that he gets.
I think, honestly, I think it's the consistency in his, like, I don't want to say compete level, but in his, like, he has to play, Naz has to play with a certain amount of grit and determination, right? He is what I consider, as skilled as he is, he's a power forward, you know? And when he's skating and he's determined and he's competitive and he's checking the right way and he's in dialed in like that, his offensive game just takes care of itself, you know? And like so many players, I think if you go and just try to skill your way through a game, it doesn't work out as successfully as if you're out there playing hard, playing for keeps. And we've seen flashes of it from Naz. Naz has been a good player for us for a couple of years, but this year he's elite, you know? I think he's leading our team in scoring right now with 76 or 77 points. And it's far and above a career year for him. And he just keeps playing the same way. It's like every night I know exactly what to expect from him. Every once in a while, like any player, you're going to have a bad night, but it's just right back to really determined hockey and And then his skill is just shining through, you know,
That's
and
cool.
he's finding a way to put the puck in net. Gets us a big goal last night to get us within one again. And you know, we have a couple chances to tie it. And we just didn't get it done. But he's a guy that I really rely on this year heavily in a bunch of different areas.
There's a player who's top five in the NHL in points right now, and Jared Bednar says that if he puts offense first, if he's focused on his offense first, it doesn't happen. He's got to take care of who Nazem Kadri is, which is first and foremost a power forward that gets gritty, that checks hard, that plays the game the right way. When he does that first, the offense will take care of himself. Now, how many times have you seen a player, maybe you can see that in yourself, where you're worried more about the offense, more about the points, more about the goals, and when the emphasis is on that, nothing happens. So Nazem Kadri, a top five player in the NHL, has got to put grit first. He's got to be a 200-foot player first. He's got to play on that edge, be a power forward, and Jared Bednar says the offense will come next. Next is a conversation I heard while driving on the NHL Network, and it was where Mike Rupp shared a story from his time with the Pittsburgh Penguins, playing alongside Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin. He was rolling at the time, and Dan Bylsma stopped him before the game was about to start and reminded him about his player identity. You're going to love this one.
Different because this is more personal for me, but when I was in Pittsburgh, Dan Bylsma was the coach, and I had a real hot start to my season. I think around December, I was, you know, second on the team in goals with like 12 goals or something like that. And that wasn't my MO. That's not what I was as a player. I remember starting a game at home and the national anthem out there for the national anthem. I've got Sidney Crosby as my center, Evgeny Malkin as the right winger, me as left wing. And so I'm chomping at the bit to get this game going. Like, what an opportunity for a role player like me to be able to play with these guys, right? National anthem ends. I go over to the bench to get a squirt of the water bottle, get going. I'm all jacked up. Dan Bylsma goes, Rupper. And I look at him and he goes, you're not out there to score a goal. it was like bringing it back down to earth. And I'm like, okay, all right, I gotcha. You know, and here's the point. Scoring goals is fun. That's what we all want to do. That's the name of the game. You got to score more than the opponent. But let's not forget who you are and where your success comes from. And my success was playing the game, forechecking hard, finishing hits, and I got goals from it. That doesn't mean I'm a goal scorer. That's how I got to score goals.
So there's a great story from Mike Grupp talking about himself and how now, and even at the time, he understood what Bylsma was trying to tell him. That Rupper had to do A, B, and C before D, E, and F would happen. And that A, B, and C was go to the net, bang bodies, remove people from pucks, and good things would happen for Mike Rupp offensively. But he couldn't start thinking that he was a goal scorer, an offensive guru, because everything else would fall apart. So the reminder from his coach wasn't to tell him that, you know, don't dream big or don't score goals, but you have to understand who you are as a player in order to have greater results and to be better in the long run. Thank you for watching this week's Lesson from a Pro on player identity. I hope you enjoyed the content. I'm Jason Podolin with Up My Hockey. And if you enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe. Click the bell so you get updates on my videos. And that is what I do. I try to help players get to where they want to go and to unleash their potential within. So you can also check me out at www.upmyhockey.com for my services and for individuals and for teams. And I hope you guys have a great day. Play hard and keep your head up. Just watch me now.